Hi everybody, I just wanted to do a very quick vlog entry just to reflect upon my year in photography. So we're sat here now in the vortex between Christmas Day and New Year's Day, where we don't quite know what day of the week it is. But I just want to say in advance, Happy New Year to you all, and I hope you've all had a wonderful Christmas. And I just want to reflect a bit on the year I've had photography-wise. It's been a strange year in a lot of ways, but before lockdown, sort of January, February time, I had the idea of putting together a photography community in Brumtography, the Facebook group, and I got that started, and that's now on just under 500 members. It's steadily growing through the year. Just before lockdown, we got a few kind of physical in-person meets rather than virtual content, and we went to the likes of the Electric Cinema in Birmingham. We also went to Ghetto Golf, we also went to Roxy's Ballroom, we did a Birmingham nighttime walk, we also did some wall wire and some long exposures, and we did a creative playground. Went to the Serb Orthodox Church in Bourneville. Did various other things as well. I can't remember them all, but it was a great start to the group. Obviously, then we were hit by lockdown, but me and the admin team have been ensuring that regular content has been going out, and that there's been challenges and stuff going on in the virtual world of Brumtography to keep the growth going, keep it ticking over, and hopefully 2021 we'll see restrictions eased a little bit, and we can get back to doing what we always wanted to do, which was, you know, meetups in person and all that kind of stuff. And we've provisionally got an exhibition, the group's first exhibition, booked for 2021 as well, depending on how it all plays out in the early part of 2021. So it's exciting times for the group. Lockdown, I got quite creative with my photography. I put the finishing touches to book two, Sinspiration, that will be coming in 2021. Did a lot of sort of very different, very creative photography. Had a spell there where I got into doing wildlife stuff in my backyard. Got two photos in particular, a lovely one of a robin and a lovely one of a squirrel. Did some other creative stuff to boost up my Redbubble page and my Getty Images portfolio of images, stock of images. And yeah, just tried to muddle through as best I could photography wise, made a lot of plans for the other side of lockdown, the major one of which being what was initially me tentatively going into exploring the feasibility of doing some sports photography, maybe as a one-off, but started doing it, started getting recognised as being good at it, started getting a taste for it, and I can now say it probably is my photography niche. And the latter part of the year, when there's been sports behind closed doors and what have you, has been, you know, building the foundations of hopefully something very special in that area, with the aspiring dream of being a pro sports photographer one day, even though that's probably a million miles away at this moment in time. But yeah, that's been a lot of what I've been about lately. And my calendars, did a Redditch United calendar and my own landscape calendar, as I usually do at this time of year. So yeah, it's been, I'd say it's been a productive year photography wise and here's hoping that lifting restrictions, hopefully by the summer of 2021 or at some point in 2021, we'll see a lot more going on in terms of, I'm itching to get back to London. Those of you that know me know that in sort of 2018, 2019, I was on average visiting London every sort of 8 to 10 weeks. Can't wait to get back down there. I think if I remember rightly, I squeezed one visit in about January, February. I did another all-nighter, but I've not been down there since. That's quite a long time for me to have been away from London town. And also, yeah, getting some physical meetups for Brumtography would be my number one priority as well. So yeah, here's to 2021, hoping it'll be a bit bit better of a year. It can't get much worse than 2020 has been, sort of spring onwards. So yeah, he's hoping and wishing you all a happy new year. And I'm gonna put some of my favourite photos from the year on the end of this vlog entry now. So I'll speak to you soon. Bye.